strange combination of feelings, but a trio that swallows all the athletes gathered here today. They are the best of the best. From all over the globe, they have come here to compete in the world's most prestigious water skiing event. It's all on the line for this, the Overton's U.S. Open. Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships presented by Chevy Trucks and Vortec Engines. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Lake Lago Santa Fe here in Houston. Dan Debenham alongside Dave Benzel. And Dave, this is truly a world championship when you talk about 12 different countries represented here, 90 skiers all vying for the coveted title of U.S. Open champion. The best in the world are here.
And they're here to compete in slalom skiing, trick skiing, and jumping. But not only was it difficult to get here, but you had to get past quite a few people to get to the final round. For instance, in men's slalom, there were 48 competitors trying to get those top six spots for the finals. We'll see the top six men in tricks and jumping as well. We'll watch the top four in women's slalom, trick, and jump.
I want to go back to the discipline of slalom skiing and a couple of other disciplines as well, Dave. Really, here at these U.S. Open Championships, maturity and experience has risen to the surface, hasn't it?
Well, we're going to see both ends of the spectrum because, yes, Andy Mappel and Corey Pikos, they've been around forever. They're pushing 40 years old, and they're still the world's best. On the other end, we're going to see young Michelle Simpson and Tara Benzel. Michelle in slalom and Tara in the trick event. They're 19 years old, just finished their freshman year.
Benzel?
Yeah, that is true. There's a Benzel in there.
We'll find out more about that. Coming up, it's the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. And we start with the tricking competition. Two passes, one hand hold and the other a toe hold pass. This is Tara Benzel, your daughter, Dave.
Yeah, I've been watching her ski for a long time, and she's had a great summer. This year she won the junior U.S. Open title in tricks and overall. She's set up here for a toe hold 720, two complete revolutions.
I've been working really hard to get to this point. It's always been my goal to ski well on the pro level. And so every day I'm out skiing all three events. Tricks has been my favorite since I was really little, though. So to break through in tricks first would make sense.
Lifelong dream coming true here at the U.S. Open, but she goes down hard.
Well, that'll be a disappointing fall here, and it all goes back to this trick right here. She wraps in, she's kind of slaloming back and forth, and she has an inadvertent wake cross. She didn't want to cross the wake there. Then she rushes this trick and catches the tip.
Here's a good look at Ronnie Barton, originally out of California, now living in Florida. Of course, that is the chosen state for the greatest water skiers in the world. 27 years old, terrific in her younger years in the junior ranks, and now one of the top pros in the sport.
Ronnie's such a seasoned competitor and so skilled in all three events, but she's always been gifted here in the trick event.
I started the year really strong at Moomba, on the podium in multiple events. I won the overall title. I backed up a little bit here in the middle of the season, not necessarily posting bad performances, but I've kind of pulled myself down a little bit to get ready to amp back up for the World Championships in September. You have to do that. We certainly can't go strong from February to September, so everything's going according to my game plan right now, and the next 3 weeks I'm really going to be building into the World Championships.
Of course, she would love to have a U.S. Open title under her belt as she heads to those World Championships. This might help get it done.
Beautiful flips here, crossing both wakes in midair and getting set up here for the third flip with a twist. Watch this landing. Excellent.
So Ronnie Barton gearing up for those World Championships. That happens in just a couple of weeks outside of Orlando, Florida. Here's a good look at Mandy Nightingale. And as Mandy warms up, let's go ahead and visit with Ronnie Barton.
Ronnie, there's always a certain amount of pressure in the U.S. Open, in the trick event especially. Tell me about the pressure you felt to stand up second skier off the dock.
Well, the pressure in the trick event for me today was riding a lot more on the overall title right now than the trick event. And unfortunately, I backed off my run in the trick event today, which could leave the door open for one of the other girls to win tricks. But I hadn't had a stand-up round yet for the overall, and I needed to give myself a chance to trick over seven for the overall. So that's what I went out there and did. So I think I was double nervous just because it was tricks and overall all on the line at one time.
Well, she said the door has been open for somebody else to possibly win the trick title here at the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships, possibly Mandy Nightingale, 23 years old, out of Oklahoma, 5'4", and she began skiing when she was just 3 years old.
And this is a gifted athlete, one who has even had tryouts for the WNBA. At 5'4", she is a superstar basketball player.
Obviously a point guard.
Doing her toe hold tricks here. Very difficult reverse toe wake back to back. Now some surface turns. She'll go to the wake here in just a second. Grabs the rope. Yes. Now let's watch for a toe hold step over trick. Yeah, there it is. Jumps over the line for the last trick of the pass.
And Mandy is excited about landing that. Let's see how many points she's going to get. 3,740. That combined with her first pass puts her into the lead right now in this tricks competition. Here's Italy's Marina Mosti getting ready to get wet and attack the water. OLN coverage of the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships is brought to you by Overton's, the world's largest water sports dealer. By Chevy Trucks and GM Vortec Engines. By Mastercraft, the leader in pulling farther ahead. And by USA Waterski, having fun today, building champions for tomorrow.
If you like to have fun on the water, you should know Overton's, the world's largest online water sports dealer. Call today for a free Overton's catalog featuring everything from water skis and wakeboards to boating accessories. Or visit us at Overton's.com for weekly specials and closeout savings. And while you're there, enter our $115,000 Super Summer Sweepstakes for a chance to win a Mastercraft boat and other great prizes. At Overton's, nobody beats our customer service, and nobody beats our prices. Call or visit Overton's.com today.
Hello, this is Mark. I won't be in the office this morning because of urgent business, but your call is very important to me, so please leave a message and I'll call you back as soon as I can pull myself away.
A new level of performance from Acura, the all-new TSX.
There's nothing worse than being ready to go and your car won't. So we're ready in advance. Ready with the right equipment, the right people, and the right parts. All at ready-to-go, low prices. And if it's your battery, we'll install it for free. So bring it on. We're ready in advance.
For the best parts, people, and price. We're ready in advance.
Yeah, bring it on.
Hey, OLN fans. Want even more cycling and adventure racing action? Well, you got it. Tune in every Thursday night for OLN Summer Sports Zone with Kirsten Gumm and the one and only Bob Roll, bringing you the latest from the Peloton and an inside look from around the world. Also, weekly features on training and fitness with Chris Carmichael and Get Geared with Paul Hockman. OLN Summer Sports Zone, Thursdays at 9. The Outdoor Life Network, pushing the big ring.
And welcome back to Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. We are in the middle of the tricks competition. Right now, Marina Mosti from Italy has come a long way for a shot at this country's most prestigious water ski event. 29 years old, now living in Florida.
She's coming back from some injuries, probably as lean as I've ever seen her. Pound for pound, one of the strongest women on the field. There's not an ounce of fat on this young lady, and she can ski all three events very well. great toe tricks. Look at the rope control here. Moving quickly from trick to trick. Being sure to get up in the air as she comes off each wake trick. Tricks must be done in the air on the wake tricks and continuous on the surface to get full credit.
Whoa, a little bobble there on that last trick. Will it be enough to surpass Mandy Nightingale? She waits and wonders. The final scores are in. Mandy Nightingale is our winner. 7,360 points is good enough.
Mandy, congratulations. A victory here. I know you came last year and won one round, but not the one that counted. How does this one feel?
Well, this one feels a lot better. In the prelims, I skied pretty well and then just enough to get in for the next round. And so skiing well in the finals really was a good thing for me and redeeming myself from last year's fall really early. So it's really great to have another win.
And now it's time for the men to attack the course. This is Jarrett Llewellyn psyching himself up. Let's find out more about this prestigious event.
Each year when we come to the U.S. Open, we expect to see this man, Steve McDermott, Executive Director of USA Water Ski, the governing organization for the sport of water skiing. Why is this event so important to USA Water Ski?
Well, Dave, it is the crown jewel for our sport. It's the best of the best competitors. We're in at a site where world records can be set. We have a great host city. We have 40,000 members who get to read about it in our magazine. We really like the exposure we get out of the U.S. Open because so many people see it and then they want to try it themselves.
Well, Jarrett Llewellyn has been a three-event skier for a lot of years. Out of Canada originally, and once again, no surprise, now living and training in Florida.
And he's built perfectly for this, the trick skiing event, although most people now know, of course, of his jumping skills. Many forget the fact that he is a 10,000-plus point tricker. And here's why. Look at this. Here come the flips. Begins with the forward flip, one of the toughest flips that there is to do. He'll have a total of about six flips in this run. Here comes another one with a twist, back landing, very difficult, and back to back.
He is so strong. He
and
just
fast.
Launches himself over those wakes.
When you watch from this angle, you can really see how he has to attack each flip. He's on a hard edge, cutting all the way in, and then launches. Look how high he is in the air, and then must stick that back landing. What an athlete.
And picks up 5,690 points in that pass. Corey Pikos, the veteran, now knows the mark to beat. Well, Dave's made it down to the dock, and he is now standing by with Jarrett Llewellyn.
Jared, tell me what you're thinking about when you went on the water today for the finals. I know you're in the overall race. You want to turn a good trick score.
Yeah, just coming in today, I was just really, you know, this morning I was laying in bed thinking, you know, hard run, easy run. And then, you know, just with the overall final, Jimmy's really putting the screws to me. He's, you know, yesterday jumped unbelievable. And, you know, I went out and did my easy run, stuck with that, nailed it. A little bobble at the end because I went too big almost on the trick that I did yesterday. And I'm really pleased with it and just looking forward to really jumping far today.
Everybody talking about that overall title while we still have a tricks title here to compete for. Corey Pikos has won the last five U.S. Open tricks titles. He is a legend in this sport.
He's been so consistent for so long. He still trains every single day with the same passion that he had when he was 13 years old. And here's why. Look at this.
Oh, no. Now, what a surprise. He goes down just as we were talking about all of his experience. What in the world happened?
Well, this shows you the nature of tricks. Anything can happen. And when you start with a difficult trick like this, going from the back position into a flip and trying to land backwards, he just blew up at an impact.
Well, he is not going to make it six times in a row here at these U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. Jimmy Seemers, on the other hand, coming off a great year last year, he has exploded onto the scene.
This is another guy who's built a lot like Jarrett Llewellyn. Perfect body size for both jump and tricks. Struggles with slalom, but watch this guy trick. He is so fast, and this is his best pass, his handheld pass. That is a 540-degree trick over the line. Now he goes into the flip series. Look how quickly he'll move from one flip to the other. It's just land and cut right back. There's another one. I mean, he's got more flips than he knows what to do with. Do not try this at home on your living room floor. Oh, jumping over the line and landing in the back position. He is hot today.
Boy, he sure is. That should be enough to surpass Jarrett Llewellyn. Let's take a look at the score as we take a look at the replay. 6,470 points. He is currently in first place. Good looking pass here.
But he's so dialed in. There isn't a bobble any place. He just keeps moving from trick to trick. Think about it. One single bobble can throw the whole rhythm off, and he's dialed in.
And psyched. Woo!
That's the gymnastics event right there.
One final competitor remaining. This man, Nicholas LaForestier. What will he do?
Jimmy, you've started the day off really well. Go off the dock, put the pressure on both Trix and overall with that stand-up pass.
Yeah, Dave, I sure did. I know I'm about 30 points behind Jarrett coming into the Trix here for the overall competition, and I really needed that to make up a little points for the overall race.
Well, can Seamers hang on? Nicholas LaForestier, this is the only event, Dave, that he has never won.
I know that he's hungry for this. He's a very ambitious man. He trains very hard, 30 years old, but probably has become the most consistent tricker in the 11,000 point range.
Well, and you saw that he has won the last three major events that he has entered in the Trix competition.
Starting with a trick very similar to what Corey fell on, only he makes it. Oh, look at this. What a recovery there. Literally bounced back to the forward position and saved himself, and now he's well on his way. Great recovery skills. Moving on here to the ski line tricks, 540-degree turns, and the reverse. Whoa, and 720 over the line. What a run.
Dave, he was just locked. He was willing himself to this. I mean, here, watch how he bounces and skips, but he will not go down.
This is pure athleticism here. He realizes he's in trouble, gets his head back up, and then gets right back into sync. Doesn't lose a moment because he doesn't have a moment to spare. He's got to get every trick in the 20 seconds.
Nicholas LaForestier wins his first U.S. Open tricks competition.
Nicholas, the score just came in. Maybe we were surprised. You said, I didn't trick very pretty today, but good enough to win.
I'm not surprised. It was not pretty, but I knew that tricks were credit. So I was like more disappointed in myself because I didn't ski clean, and that for the Worlds or the Europeans, it might take more to win. So I really wanted to put up a big score. But that's enough to win here today, so that I'm pretty happy about that.
And we'll be back with more right here on OLN, the home of water skiing. Jumping's next from Houston.
I thought about getting a satellite dish.
They advertise a two-room package.
Now, I've got this living room, the kids' playroom, and my bedroom. That's more than two rooms.
I'd need more receivers or rabbit ears. Charter Communications lets me watch what I want and where I want.
Call now and upgrade to Charter Digital Cable for free. 1-800-955-7766.
Two rooms? I've got more than two rooms.
When you think it's time to buy a new car, you've got a lot to think about. And the information you need to make the right decision is at vehix.com. VHICS.com gives you all the facts, the makes, the models, the engine, the transmission, the power locks, the power windows, the stereo, the airbags, the headroom, the hip room, the legroom, the colors outside, the colors inside, and of course, the prices. So don't go in circles. Go to the all-new, easy-to-use VHICS.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
The PBR has them all. The pretty boy, the wild child. But there's only one they call the legend.
Trent Shivers, what a ride!
24 years old with one title already under his belt.
The guy's my hero.
And he's determined to capture his second world title. Nerves of steel and the heart of a champion have taken him far. But Shivers will have to prove his worth 8 seconds at a time. The PBR, tonight at 8 p.m. on the Outdoor Life Network.
Where can you go to do it all? See it all. Taste it all. Buy it all. And still afford it all. Houston Space City, a space of infinite possibilities. Call 1-800-4-HOUSTON and book your getaway today.
With capabilities that will amaze you, both on-road and off, Ford Explorer is the most trusted SUV in America.
Sorry, I'm late.
We took a wrong turn at Greenland.
If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Dos Equis. Sooner or later, you'll get it.
Welcome back to the Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. Dan Debenham with Dave Benzel. We are here in Houston, and it's time to fly. It is time for the jumping competition, Dave.
Well, the guys are fired up because Jimmy Siemers has inspired everyone by jumping 235 feet in the preliminary round. He's put a mark out there. That's a world record mark. And guys like Freddie Krueger and, of course, Jarrett Llewellyn are eager to go after him. We've got a slight headwind, and that means let's stay up in the air a long, long time.
All right, let's get to it. If you've got a need for speed and like hitting a ramp at about 65 miles an hour, you're going to love the jumping competition. We will check out the guys in just a bit. But first, the women, Marina Mosti.
Marina out very wide here, getting started, accelerating into the base of the ramp. Beautiful form. Probably not enough speed for a huge jump, but she's got great form, and you could see her get right out over the tips as she left the top of the ramp.
Well, it's her third jump, and it's a 162, and that's her best jump. Each competitor does get three jumps, and they will score the best jump. Here's Ronnie Barton now, and she can fly, Dave.
In the preliminaries, I had a 166-foot jump. I certainly don't expect that to hold up, but I'm definitely capable of going in the mid-170s myself. I need to tweak a few things, and I hope to put together a big jump in the finals.
She'll need a big jump here. Right now, the mark to beat, 162.
As you watch her leave the top of the ramp, you can see her body is leaning over the left ski. That's not exactly where she's going to get her greatest distance. She's got to keep more weight on the right ski and hold her direction.
Well, she does have one final crack at the ramp. There's Emma Shears. She's kind of the grand dame of jumping. She'll watch Ronnie Barton one more time.
Nice turn to the ramp. Digging in hard right there, and better body position. Now, she's not pleased with that, and a skier has a real sense about how far they go.
Well, it's not going to be far enough. A 158 on that third and final jump. What happened?
Well, she's just a little bit back, not able to get the vertical lift that she wants, even if she had the speed.
Here's Jennifer Kaiser surveying the situation. And in fact, what's happened to the wind?
I would think Jennifer's wondering the same thing. You know, they love a headwind, and we referred to a slight breeze earlier. It's gone. All of a sudden, it has dropped. We're left looking at pretty calm conditions. That's not a bad thing, but a headwind would be better. Holding out wide here, waiting for that opportune moment to cut to the ramp. Timing is everything. Good speed, and you know, Jennifer's been jumping well all summer. She has surprised a lot of people by being here in the finals.
That one's not going to get it done, though. Jump number one, a 155.
Yeah, and she's capable of going in the 70s. Great form, not enough speed. If the women were counting on that headwind to hold them up, they're going to have to make some adjustments and cut later to the ramp and put it all out there on their own energy because the wind's not there to help them.
It's all about speed.
And lift. We've got to have this explosion right off the top of the ramp. Now, you see the skis bank out a little bit? That might be a little farther, but only on speed. She didn't get the lift.
Right. They seem to slip out at the last moment. And that, in fact, is just a 158. Again, you see those skis slipping right there, Dave.
There's so much energy coming into the ramp, and it's controlling that energy that gives you a long jump. If things are sliding or turning, coming out of position, you lose distance.
Which is why you need strength in this sport, and this woman's got it. Emma Shears.
Emma is the biggest threat to the existing world record, a 186-foot leap by Elena Milikova from Russia. And Emma Shears is chasing it and capable of that kind of distance.
Of course, she can do more than just jump.
I'm so happy to be in both the slalom and the jump finals. It's awesome for me to be here at the US Open. I just love this event, and it's been so good to me in the past, and I'm looking forward to the finals.
Well, she needs to go further than 162. Is that going to do it, Dave?
Oh, look at this.
Oh, yeah.
It's a huge jump. Nobody cuts as late at the ramp as Emma Shears and can hold that body position all the way through the ramp.
We talked about her strength, and that's where she has it, right there.
And she's still twisted a little coming off the top. She's got more in her than what we just had there, and that's a winning jump.
Marina Mosti knows that Emma Shears has surpassed her 162. Congratulations.
That 180-foot jump has to feel good when you sail out there, and you didn't even have a headwind today.
Oh, no, I'm just, like, super excited. It was, I've been working on my sit-ups all weekend and with my brother Curtis and my husband Rick, and we've just been working on a little thing at a time, and it all came together today, and I'm just absolutely so excited.
Congratulations on a great victory.
Thank you very much.
And when we come back, how appropriate. The Rockets will take off here in Houston. The guys take to the sky after this.
The powerful Silverado is here. Still available with the proven 340 horse Vortec V8.
And now, the choice is clear, to buy it now or start my bidding. The thing is there, it could be here. Can't live without it, who am I kidding? Bags, clothes, lamps, this PDA. I click buy it now. It's on its way through auctions without delay. You can do it eBay.
Sports Illustrated Swimsuit. Men everywhere anticipate the annual pilgrimage to the beach. Catch the world's most beautiful models hard at work in exotic locations around the globe. Heidi, Molly, Tyra. Fellas, try and pay attention. Every Tuesday night at 10, it's Sports Illustrated Swimsuit. Right here on OLN. Out you go.
Behind him is a 400-square-foot deluxe bachelor with a partial view. In front of him is a junior executive semi-private with no view. But right now, life is perfect. On the open road, in complete control of an Acura RSX. One of Car and Driver's 10 best.
You're watching the Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships presented by Chevy Trucks and GM Vortec Engines. We are in Houston, Texas, as we are set now for the men's jumping competition. This is Scotty Ellis.
Scotty, I remember watching him jump as a junior boy. He has always been tenacious, cutting into the base of the ramp. This year, his performances have been up and down a little bit. He's capable of hitting the world record mark, but he's been back there in the pack, sort of in the middle of the group.
He'd like to just launch off this and show he is back.
Oh, this is a great start. Oh, rough landing. You know, there's no points deducted for a rough landing, but it beats you up, and that one definitely beat him up.
217, his best jump of his three. He is way up there.
He's been able to come through with a big jump when he needs it, but watch this landing. This is a head slammer, and that'll rattle his bell a little bit, but he did have good speed and lift.
Jarrett Llewellyn now knows the mark to beat. A 217. Will it be enough to win the competition, though?
Scott, while I know that 217 wasn't what you wanted, you were milking that thing for every inch. It looked like it was a rough landing.
It was really rough. Once I came back in, I put my skis down, and I told Curtis he was getting ready. He's like, I'm a little dizzy after that landing. I mean, like you said, I was going after every inch, and I got everything I could out of it, but I got roughed up a little bit.
He did give it his all, 217. This is Jarrett Llewellyn, who loves to jump.
The reason why I love to jump is just, you know, the competition, the excitement, you know, and the power. You know, just to fly through the air, it's incredible. The farther you go, you just want to go farther and farther.
Well, that's his first jump, and that's a pretty good jump. Is it better than 217? It's close, that's for sure.
Jarrett is a master at holding his body position into the base of the ramp. His right ski pivoted out on this one. This is not what he's capable of. He's got a lot more in him.
215, that's still 20 feet short of this guy's world mark he set yesterday at 235. Here's Jarrett Llewellyn one more time.
This is the counter cut. He's out very wide now on the driver's side of the boat. Watch this turn. Skis come around 90 degrees and he blasts into the ramp. Look at this. Oh, much longer float time. He's in the air much longer and he knows that was farther.
217 is the mark to beat, set down by Scott Ellis. 225.
And you can tell the difference. He just held on with two hands a little longer. He held his direction through the ramp and the float time tells the story.
225, that is a huge jump.
You can see him come up over the top. They speak of this feeling of coming up over the top in the air, getting pulled up over your tips, and then just hanging on for dear life.
Better tighten up those gloves, knock the helmet for good luck, and get ready. Jesper Casso says, I'm ready. Hit it. The Mastercraft will pull him at a nice, even speed.
That speed being 35 miles an hour. The ramp 6 foot high for this jumper at 5'10". The ramp's bigger than he is.
That's a good point.
And, you know, it looks like a barn door when you're coming in there at about 65 miles an hour. This ramp looks huge. And then it's launch time. Ooh, look at this. Beautiful form. Jesper's been surprising a lot of skiers. Getting into the finals here is a big feather in his cap.
Well, he has a 219 and a 221 here in the finals. How far is this one? Another 221. Close, but not enough.
Great form, tight line. And you could tell, look at the landing. That tells you something about the jump itself. Freddy Krueger getting focused. Let's talk to Dan about power in this event.
I don't know if the Chevy truck looks familiar to you, but certainly the Mastercraft should. Yeah, this is the same boat that is pulling the best water skiers in the world here at the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. Yeah, in fact, this is the boat that just helped Jimmy Seemers to a new world record in the ski jump competition. This exact boat is what he trains behind every day. Now, there's a couple of reasons why he was able to go 235. One of the reasons is the hull designed by Mastercraft. It kind of creates a wakeless wake, if you will. No wake. That's what you want when you're trying to cross it at 75 miles an hour. Also, that hull design helps create less than a 2-inch deviation when you're going down the course. That is the beauty of this boat. But what about the brawn? Oh man, look at this. The Vortex 6000. This is the exact same engine as in that Chevy truck, maybe your Chevy truck at home, except for it has been marinized by the folks at Inmar. They have custom calibrated this engine specifically for this boat. Now when that happens, you put it all together, the folks from Chevy, Inmar, Mastercraft, and Vortex, hey man, you got yourself a winner. Or in this case, you've got a new world record.
Freddy Krueger and the rest of the jumpers ready to take advantage of that power when we come back.
When you think it's time to buy a new car, you've got a lot to think about. And the information you need to make the right decision is at vehix.com. vehix.com gives you all the facts, the makes, the models, the engine, the transmission, the power locks, the power windows, the stereo, the airbags, the headroom, the hip room, the legroom, the colors outside, the colors inside, and of course, the prices. So don't go in circles. Go to the all-new, easy-to-use vehix.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
Another great reason to work for Charter Media.
The most fun thing about my job at Charter Media, it allows me to be really creative. I get to be around different people, be around different equipment. Every day is not the same old thing. It's always something different, each and every day.
For more information about a career with Charter Media, log on to www.charter.com or tune into On TV 10.
The fun on the water. You should know Overton's, the world's largest online water sports dealer. Call today for a free Overton's catalog featuring everything from water skis and wakeboards to boating accessories. Or visit us at Overton's.com for weekly specials and closeout savings. And while you're there, enter our $115,000 Super Summer Sweepstakes for a chance to win a Mastercraft boat and other great prizes. At Overton's, nobody beats our customer service, and nobody beats our prices. Call or visit Overton's.com today.
The Chevy Trailblazer worst-case scenario. What to do if tailgated by a giant ore hauler? Don't slow down or pull one of those I'm braking slightly to freak you out stunts. You won't like the results. Simply let that standard 275 horsepower Vortec engine send a clear message. Get off my rear, ore man. Here you have a best case scenario. Chevy Trailblazer. Like a rock.
Dos Equis. Sooner or later, you'll get it.
Five-star premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
Good crowd here in Houston for the Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. You know, when you're a fan of this sport, you seem to be hooked for a lifetime.
Skiers stay involved in this sport in lots of different ways and for many years. In the case of Daryl Moore, Daryl, you competed here as a professional a number of years ago, maybe back 1989-ish.
Yeah.
And now you're still involved in the sport. Tell us what's going on.
Yeah, Dave, I've got a dealership here in Houston, Texas. We sell Mastercraft and Malibu ski boats. And anytime I can give back to the sport, you know, I'm willing to do that. And we sponsored this event, and it's been a great event.
Well, you know what it's like to be out on the water, and you can certainly understand what it means to these skiers to have good sponsorship.
Yeah, absolutely. When, you know, when I competed and everything else, you know, we had good sponsorship back then, and I feel like that, you know, I can help out, and I'm going to do that. It's been very successful for us.
Well, now, let me just make it clear. While I'm sure Daryl would like to say that was him on the slalom course, that was not. That was a good look at the Mastercraft. And here's a good look at Freddy Krueger, who's got a good shot at winning this jumping competition.
Well, Danny's won three out of the last four. He is hot this season, like the last couple of years since he married his wife, Karen. Now, she's a slalom specialist, but it seems to have helped his jumping because he's settled down, has become more of a perfectionist with his style, and a lot fewer crashes.
He's got to go 225 at least. Ooh, that's a good jump, but is it far enough?
Freddie attacks the jump on every single approach. He never holds back.
223, just 2 feet short of our leader right now.
He's going to be unhappy with that. He knows he's capable of getting up in the 230s, and that's a bummer for him.
Jimmy Seamers, our final jumper. Can he go better than 225? Hey, here's Freddy Krueger.
Freddy, the jumpers are coming back in here and saying, wow, the, you know, tailwind, no wind, it's back and forth. How did it catch you out there?
I caught the tailwind. I've had not only a frustrating weekend, but a frustrating summer. It's the part of the sport. In years past, I seemed like every weekend I was the guy that got the benefit, and it caught me this year. It just seems like all season, rather than get that little lucky wind spurt or whatever, it's gone the opposite on me. And in the earlier rounds, we had a nice headwind. I felt like, you know, and everybody probably feels that way, but I felt like it was laying down for me. I thought today it was staying down. I felt good about it. And then when I went out, I looked up the flag and she went tailwind on me. So, but that's the game.
A gracious Freddy Krueger who knows he was so close. Jimmy Seamers, 235 in the preliminary rounds. He is just flying out here.
Well, true. But you know, once you go out and do a 235 and break a world record, can you come back? I don't know. I don't think that was it. You know, there's a lot of pressure on you, and you had that big adrenaline rush earlier, and now he's got to come back and jump really far to beat Llewellyn.
Llewellyn's in at 225. Seamer's first jump, a 210. Jarrett Llewellyn, is this going to be enough for a U.S. Open jumping champion?
Yeah, he's sweating bullets here, sure, because he knows that Jimmy Seamers could go out right now and maybe hit 230. Now, what does Jimmy Seamers think? What's going through his head? He attacks. He is very late. Oh, great form. He is way out over the tips. He had the flow time. That's right about in the same area that Llewellyn landed his jump.
He might have it. He thinks he does. You see, he put that fist in the air. It's got to be 225 or better.
Wow, a little bit of chest drop into the ramp. It would have been better if he could have kept his back straight. Oh, no, 224. He misses by a foot.
1 foot. Jarrett Llewellyn is our winner, and he knows it right now. He saw the score. Look at that. He sees it. He says, are you kidding? I got this thing in the bag. Congratulations to Jarrett Llewellyn. Good job. He is our winner at 225 feet and really in the hunt for the overall.
Jarrett, that 225, I don't think you expected that was going to hold all day.
Not at all. Standing on the, the conditions kept changing. Everybody, for 1 second there, I thought someone was going to get a headwind, and it turned right around, and then Freddie and Jimmy ended up getting back the tailwind that I started with, and, that's just the way it is. Well, my 25, I felt really good, but I knew I left some there. I knew that, potentially in those conditions, 230 was doable.
Mother Nature plays a wonderful part of the success for Jarrett Llewellyn. When we come back, slalom skiing. Stay with us. We're in Houston. It's the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships.
Get up. Get out. Play. Enjoy. Laugh. Share. Relax. Refresh. Grow. Smile. Have more fun. USA Water Ski. Having fun today. Building champions for tomorrow. To start today, go to usawaterski.org.
Business, but your call is very important to me, so please leave a message and I'll call you back as soon as I can pull myself away.
Hours, my truck bed went from beat up to brand new.
Herculiner, the do-it-yourself brush-on bed liner, lays down a thick skid-resistant surface and looks incredible.
Do it right, do it yourself, do it with Herculiner.
Call toll-free to find the Herculiner retailer nearest you.
What time is it? Subaru all-wheel drive time. Time to get it all. Up to $2,000 in customer cash rebates depending on model, and financing as low as 0% APR. Time to get incredible savings on an incredible all-wheel drive 2003 Outback, Legacy, or Baja. That's up to $2,000 in customer cash rebates and 0% financing. Hurry to Subaru all-wheel drive time now, because time runs out September 2nd.
Welcome back to Houston, Texas, the boating capital of the Lone Star State. This all-American city has hosted Super Bowls, NCAA Final Fours, the Tennis Masters Cup, All-Star Games, Championship Rodeos, and for the second consecutive year, the Overton's U.S. Open. Yep, there is plenty to do here in Houston. The drama continues to build here at the Overton's U.S. Open Water Ski Championships. This is slalom skiing, and this is Michelle Simpson.
19-year-old skier just finished her freshman year at Rollins College, along with her teammate Tara Benzel. They both ski in the intercollegiate program there. And this is her second year in the finals here at the U.S. Open, which is a great thing for a young skier to make the finals.
Coming in at 38 off, what does that mean?
38 feet of rope taken off of the standard 75-foot rope length. This is 34 miles an hour. She's around the second buoy. Great form accelerating into the third buoy. Oh, and going out the back.
It's almost like she got her weight distribution off there. What happened, Dave?
She was really a little narrow coming into that buoy and couldn't keep the tip of the ski down, and she's out.
Natalie Hamrick up next. 2.5 buoys at 38 off the mark to beat the world record, one at 41 off, held by Christy Overton Johnson.
When Christy Overton steps on the water, everyone listens. That's because she's held the world record for only about a decade. But today you're here in another capacity because I know you're not competing, and that's kind of a surprise to us. Is this retirement?
My husband told me I can't openly come out with a retirement statement, but we are just taking a long break. And that just leaves my options open if the body starts to feel better. But my body's had a rough go at it for 29 years on the water, and I'm ready to just do something different.
Overton's has been involved with water skiing for as long as I can remember, and they're intimately involved with the U.S. Open. Tell us that story.
We're the title sponsor of the U.S. Open, and Overton's has been a longstanding supporter of water skiing since my father was, he was on the back creeks of the Pamlico River. You know, as a child, he grew up, he had me on the water, and he just loves the sport. He loves the athletes, and it's just such a joy. It gives him joy to be able to support the skiers in this capacity.
You're also here on another mission now. Talk to us about this organization called In His Wakes.
In His Wakes is a faith-based organization, and what we do are several things. One is we work with underprivileged children, kids who would not ever have the opportunity to be on the water. It's our Day to Remember program, and we give them a day to remember. We teach them the water ski, you know, Andy Mapple's out there, Jarrett Llewellyn, holding them up, teaching them to ski, and when they come in, it's just such a blessing to see the smile on their face, and we present them with a gold medal. We also do faith-based water ski shows across the nation. The shores are just packed. We market it through the churches, and it's a SeaWorld-style show packed in about an hour and a half, and it's just been incredible to see the response to that. And we also travel around to tournaments like the Overton's U.S. Open and just share with people what we're doing to raise support and also hand out our Making the Cut booklets, which has testimonies of the athletes.
Just a terrific group doing great things. All right, here's Natalie Hamrick as she gets set for this slalom competition. And she is a very tall skier, and that's to her advantage.
Oh, at 5'11"? Certainly there is an advantage, because here at 38 off, the rope is 6 inches shorter than the distance from the pylon of the boat out to the buoy. So you're going to watch this beautiful reach that she extends when she comes into buoy one. Here it is. Watch this great reach. She hooks the buoy over to the number two side. She's in pretty good shape here coming into three. She's got to get past this one. Whoa!
Oh, she lost the handle.
She pops the handle halfway between the buoy and the center of the wake, which is going to put her in a tie now. At 2.5 buoys at 38. This is surprising. I expected her to run this pass.
Well, I think she's surprised. Look at that. She just kind of leaned back, got some slack in the rope, and it popped. Well, there's our jumping champion, Emma Shears. How will she do in the slalom competition?
Natalie, you used an interesting strategy there. You ran your 28 off pass and opted up all the way to 35, ran it, and then ran into trouble at 38.
Well, this weekend has probably been the hottest event I've ever been to in my life. And there was a long wait before we slalomed, and I knew I was hot, and the water was really warm, and I just thought it might be a good strategy to ski a little less to be fresher at 38. And didn't quite work out the way that I wanted to.
Well, it is hot. It's about 98 degrees with probably 85% humidity. Let's see how Emma Shears handles that and the course. Coming in at 38 off.
Well, she got in real deep at number one. Good number two ball. Number three will tell the story. She's on her way here. Little slack at four. And again, not able to hold the slack. A tight line is always your friend. And once it goes loose, you're in trouble. As she comes into this fourth buoy, watch the slack in the rope, and she cannot hang on.
3.5 buoys at 38 off is the mark to beat for Karen Truelove.
Emma, we saw people run 38 off in the earlier rounds of this competition. Here in the finals, women are not running 38 off. What's going on? You've got the leading score.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with 3.5. I just felt really uncomfortable today out there, and so to at least get a little way down that pass, you know, I'm really pleased. But, you know, I know Karen's been skiing awesome, and she's just going to come out after me and blow that out of the water, I'm sure. So it really isn't going to be enough today, but, you know, I'm happy to be sitting in second.
Everybody talking about how uncomfortable they are. I think it's that heat, that humidity, but this woman can flat out ski.
And being last off the dock, she knows exactly what she has to do. She's got to get around the fourth buoy at 38 off, and she's got a victory. At 5'5", a little shorter, she's going to work hard to ski wide. She can do that. She's been here before.
you know, going last in the finals, you know, this year it seems like I keep ending up there. So, you know, I don't know if I'd say I'm getting used to it or not, but I'm starting to get a little more comfortable, you know, going out last because I actually enjoy it. I can kind of see what I need to do. And, you know, sometimes it works out and sometimes it doesn't. But I think it's one of those things where, you know, after you do it a couple of times, you get more comfortable with it and, you know, you just try to use it to your advantage.
And she does exactly that. Look at this. Back to the center of the wake. There's four buoys and a victory for Karen Truelove. She does it again, Dan.
Well, she said she's used to coming off the dock last, and in this case, she wins again. And for Emma Shears, total disappointment. Karen Truelove is our winner.
Karen, congratulations. Oh, I understand this is two in a row. You won here last year.
Yeah. Actually, you just reminded me. I'm trying not to think about those things when you're sitting on the dock. But, yeah, it makes it nice. And I guess this place is being good to me. It's been really hot. And like I said, when I came in, the scores were down a bit. And that was a little unnerving, you know, standing on the dock because I thought, what's wrong? You know, because all the girls are very capable of running 38. And I expected, you know, several of them, too, to do that. And the only thing I can figure, it's been about 105 here for the last 3 days. And I think everyone's just tired. Maybe we're just all a little off. But either, you know, anyway, I'll take a win no matter how it comes, and I'm excited.
Well, let's go ahead and turn our attention to the men now. This is Chris Rossi, and you know, there's not a lot of great water skiers that come from Vermont, but that is certainly the birthplace of this young man now living in Orlando.
The boat speed now is 36 miles an hour, and the rope length 41 off. We're talking short, short rope. Watch his reach and the kind of speed he develops coming through the wakes. Here's buoy number one. He's a right foot forward skier, so this would be a big turn here. Number two, whoa, he cannot get a full turn. He will get two full buoys, but he was not able to get over to the third buoy.
Jamie Bouchain likes what he sees, and when we come back, he'll be on the water with the rest of the best from Houston as our slalom competition continues.
Another great reason to work for Charter Media.
The most fun thing about my job at Charter Media, it allows me to be really creative. I get to be around different people, be around different equipment. Every day is not the same old thing. It's always something different, each and every day.
For more information about a career with Charter Media, log on to www.charter.com or tune into On TV 10.
High school football is back and better than ever. See the hottest games in the upstate with the Charter Communications High School Football Game of the Week. Charter Communications brings you the hard-hitting action from start to finish. Catch all the action Saturdays at 11 a.m. on Charter's TV 10 and Tuesdays at 8 p.m. on Charter Channel 99. Charter Communications, your home for high school football.
Led to his closest race ever. Lance Armstrong's triumphant quest for five was the most dramatic tour in years. In celebration of this epic event, OLN will present Lance Around the Clock. 25 hours of the most memorable stages, starting with the two-hour defining moments of the Tour de France. The non-stop action begins Sunday, August 31st at 9 p.m. Out you go.
If you like to have fun on the water, you should know Overton's, the world's largest online water sports dealer. Call today for a free Overton's catalog featuring everything from water skis and wakeboards to boating accessories. Or visit us at Overton's.com for weekly specials and closeout savings. And while you're there, enter our $115,000 Super Summer Sweepstakes for a chance to win a Mastercraft boat and other great prizes. At Overton's, nobody beats our customer service, and nobody beats our prices. Call or visit Overton's.com today.
With one nasty supercharged engine. Nothing can get you, nothing can touch me. When you need the power,
what?
Or not, we'll be there. Chevy.
Chevy and Power. With available OnStar.
Sooner or later, you'll get it.
U.S. U.S. Open coverage has been brought to you by USA Waterski. Having fun today, building champions for tomorrow. By Mastercraft, the leader in pulling farther ahead. By Chevy Trucks and GM Vortec Engines. And by Overton's, the world's largest water sports dealer.
As we watch Jamie Beauchesne get ready, you have to think every skier is looking for an advantage someplace. I think Dan just found a skier who has an edge.
I think I found the right place. I was told that Andy Mapple is traveling in style these days, but more importantly, I've heard that this motorhome is actually helping him, especially in conditions like this. Hey, Andy, how you doing?
Good.
You mind if we talk to you for a second?
Not at all. You guys want to cool down, don't you?
We do, actually. Yeah, we do. Come on. Well, there. Oh, man, this is nice and cool in here. Dina, how you doing?
Hey, Dan, how are you?
Great. We have Dina Mapple back here, of course, and Andy. And Andy, we were just talking. A couple of people told me that you were down here in your motorhome. And I, on a day like today, I mean, here it is, the finals, and it's got to be 96, 98 degrees, 90% humidity. Does this help prolong your career? How does this help you?
You know what? It just helps me a lot. Obviously, when it's this hot, to be able to sit this close to the starting dock, I can keep an eye on everything that's going on. But the best thing for me is just that I can travel. I can have my family with me. I've got all my stuff. I got my toys with me. You know, this is, I'm like home, you know, and I walk right out and I take a ski ride.
Yeah, and you enjoy that. You like staying on site. It's not like you go down to the local KOA either. You stay on site.
As much as I can, I like to stay on site. You know, the pressure of waking up in a hotel, figuring out I've got to get my breakfast, what time have I got to get there for traffic, get in the site. You know, all those pressures are gone. I'm just so much more relaxed staying on site that, you know, I'm just a lot more comfortable.
All right. Well, good luck. All right.
Thanks, Dan.
Jamie Beauchesne is the kind of skier who could put the pressure on an Andy Mapple because he's capable of running deep 41 off. And here he is, 26-year-old skier. He's got the height at 6'1", and he comes from New Hampshire, another one of those states where we don't get a lot of skiers, but he's trained, of course, in Florida for a long, long time. Here is 41 off.
And the mark to beat, two buoys at 41 off. Good setup.
Skis a lot like a snow skier. Gets a big turn there at number one. Watch him slam. Oh, I expected him to slam dunk that turn at two, really turn it hard. He must not have felt early enough to make a big turn. And he has tied Chris Rossi.
Boy, this, again, is this a little surprising, though? We saw it in the women's slalom. Now we're seeing it in the men's slalom.
No, in a way, it's not surprising. These guys are all so close together in terms of their upper-end capabilities. That's a huge score. And Wade Cox knows he's got to really go hard to get to number three at this rope length. He needs a big turn on both one and two ball.
Wade Cox, he's stoked to be back here at the U.S. Open.
Oh, I'm just pumped to be here, man. It's the U.S. Open. You know, I'm an American, so it's a huge event. I won it once back in 96, and geez, a second title would be unreal.
Let's see what kind of one ball he gets. Oh,
wow.
He takes an unlikely bow at the waist at ball one.
He almost did a face plant
well,
there.
Well, and once you do that, once you lose body position at this rope length, there's no coming back. You know, hang on for dear life. He gets to the wakes, but that's it.
And disappointment, obviously, for Wade, but an opportunity for this man, Andy Mapple. Here's Wade Cox.
Bruh.
Wade, these two, first two skiers went on and really put a mark out there, didn't they? Hit.
Yeah, I kind of thought they were going to do that. You know, they're young and all fired up, so that's cool. I mean, I turned and looked at Mapple right when they did that. I'm like, game on. Here we go. So it's fun. It's always great to be at the U.S. Open, especially in the final.
Well, in these finals is this man, Andy Mapple. But let's not forget that Jamie Beauchesne and Jeff Rogers, all three the co-holders of the world record here in the finals. I mean, what a tremendous lineup this is. Here comes Andy Mapple.
41 years of age, the elder statesman, and yet the best because he has won the most titles. This is 39 and a half off. We're going to get a chance to see him run this pass if he can make it to set himself up for 41 off. Wow, look at that pull. Great turn, right foot forward skier. That's his offside, which is better than some people's onside turn.
Good point.
Look at the strength here. And he rounds the sixth buoy. He's got 39 and a half off. He's going to get a chance to go after the leaders. Jamie Beauchesne knowing, here comes the master at 41 off. He must get some part of the third buoy.
If so, he's got another U.S. Open title to his credit. Around number one.
Good two. Can he get over to three?
throws his ski outside the third buoy. That is a victory.
Another title for Andy Mapple. Another trophy will go in the case as Andy Mapple proves that experience once again does rise to the occasion. Congratulations.
Andy, I know you've won a lot of these, but this was a really tough one to win. Two guys right off the dock right away put out big scores, 2 at 41 off. What were you thinking about going into 41 off?
Well, I think just before I went out, I was doing all right, keeping my body cool, but that was hard, having a hard time keeping my mind focused with the heat and stuff. And then when Chris went out and posted 2 at 41, it's like I heard Wade say, you know, we kind of looked at each other, he's like, okay, game's on now. It's like amazing how the focus came in. But, you know, the wind was kind of a tricky crosswind at 39 for me, but it helped me at 41 because I could pull long into one ball, you know, and I knew I was going to be able to shut it down. If I could get to 2, I was going to turn it.
Well, what a tight race and a great win for Ronnie Barton in the women's overall competition. 8 points better than Marina Mosty. And Jared Llewellyn is our overall winner for the men.
I'm really pleased to come up with this. I'm pretty much surprised right now.
A great day for Jared Llewellyn and the rest of the best that came to Houston to ski, fly, and trick their way to a U.S. Open title. World records were set, personal bests accomplished. It's the U.S. Open Water Ski Championships, and once again, it has brought out the best here on OLN. For Dave Benzel, I'm Dan Debenham. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.